I was so lost in this world. I couldn't find my way, oh, and I praise God today. I can say I'm saved.
Joy in my heart since my burden rolled away, and I'll sing of His love today. I've been saved. Oh, I'm saved.
Praise God, we are saved. Not because of our own merits, but because of Christ's merits. One of the things that I always look forward to when I come to church is to listen to people singing. And especially when Faife Au Setu and Anna sing. They were at Fulton when I was working there. And they used to sing together. Well, manuia kausanga fo.
Manuia Christmas.
You know, I really enjoyed the watching the talents today. For me, this is one of the best platforms where we can promote our message.
Yeah, my lesi lei tu ainga e mafai ona failoai ia se fautaua.
Though there may be some that went overboard.
Yeah, e wi lava wa faisi overteleo falinga nisi.
But we're still working on it.
Yeah, I a lot of lava ina ia.
I really like to, you know, seeing those children performing today.
Yeah, vi fia lava I fa nausa fa penan fa tino ina ni vaenga ni asu.
In a way that we can all understand. So I salute the children's ministry for their program today. Probably by now you would have been informed that there will be a women's congress, or more like a festival of Lady for the Women next year in Tonga.
Salo wo to fa fonga ye ia se fono a tele a tina matamai ta ye fa ia lea ile to sang fo.
Lest I forget, before I forget, the women's ministry director asked me to promote it while I'm here.
Ya mai te ngalo e tau len fa mai te ta ia le vaenga tina matamai ta ina ia fa lau I loa a o ye te minei I America Samoa.
And I'm promoting it to you now. Hopefully, you'll be able to come to Tonga next year.
There
is nothing in Tonga to see. Because you can stand from the other side and look over to the other side. There is no mountain. But I believe you will enjoy your time together, fellowshipping with other women from our region. Last night I talked to you about the biblical perspective or definition of a transformed person. And we were reminded last night that transformation is a process. It is a work of a lifetime. From a biological perspective, we call it as metamorphosis. It is how a small caterpillar develop into an adult, a
butterfly.
So when we are born again, when we are converted, Paul calls us that we become babies when we are converted. And we are babies in the hands of God. And the Spirit works in our hearts to make us strong and become matured in life. So transformation is a work of a lifetime. And it is done by the Holy Spirit. But please be reminded again tonight, friends, that being transformed does not mean that we are immune from apostasy and deficiency. Being transformed does not mean that we are immune from fallacy and non-conformity. In other words, being transformed does not mean that we are immune from all the evil influences of the world. The battle continues on in our lives. And the evil forces will still pull us to the side. And so tonight, I will focus more on the things that probably that still holds us back.
Yeah, Yes, we are
transformed. I believe that. And may I see the hands of those who believe that they are transformed. Yes, remember we are transformed, but we are an unfinished product. We are a work in progress. However, though we are transformed, the spirit of the devil continues to fight with us every single moment of our
life.
May I see the hands of those who watch the match between Joseph Parker and Anthony Joshua.
Yes, si awila tau e the mai moa ile pusu angale Joseph Parker ma.
Did you
Joshua.
Watch that? Hey, some people
yeah.
did not watch it. Eh? Don't lie. I know you all watch it.
Ele mai moa ila to telo ta tau pusu angale.
Now I want you to watch carefully. There is also another boxing match. Two different boxing matches tonight. I want you to watch. Because the message focuses more on this. This is the first one. And remember, these people here are transformed members of God. Please enjoy watching. The other one. Where is the one that was there? That's the one. Okay. No. They're not Tongans. Are they Tongans? Are you sure? But they look like Samoans. Okay, that is just a part of the boxing match. Those were Tongans in America, straight after church. These are people that we call transform. And yet, they were still fighting after church.
ya America tangat tonga ya ai umaya ale kalesi le lotu ya ona file of tawinga fa for fasa.
And as a Tongan, I am not proud to watch that.
Ya le langona lava se fie fie ba ai itunga ata le ve yo mtangat tonga.
But I'm confident to say that because we are not the only ones. This is another Tongan man. But his father and mother are from
Samoa.
So let's just enjoy a little bit of this. Maybe some of these people here are related to you. I don't think that they are Samoans.
Yeah, I long in Samoa.
You know, this is really a concern for me.
O se me tua langona ile maftia tia.
Because it's getting worse.
O se atu ngalunga ona ua faa teleina leleanga.
We call ourselves as transformed people. And yet, this is the reality that happens in the church. And friends, tonight, it's even getting worse in the churches in the overseas places. Most of the island churches in New Zealand, Australia, and America are fighting every
year.
You know, I'm happy that American Samoan Seventh-day Adventist churches are not fighting. They just stopped yesterday.
Yeah, na.
But these are people that we call transform. Friends, let me share with you tonight the reason why I think that caused all this. And it is taken from the book of Judges. You see, the book of Judges, let us look at the background first. Written by Prophet Samuel around 1050 to 1000 BC. And the book of Judges present us with a sad and turbulent period in Israel's history. Very bad. Before that, Joshua talks about different victories in the battles that Israel fought. Whereas the book of Judges shows the failure of Israel to conquer their enemies. Claim their inheritance. And live in peace with God. So that's the book of Joshua, and this is the book of Judges.
Or
in other words, the book of Joshua talks about the God as the victorious God. On the other side, the book of Judges talk about God as the defeated God, our God. Because the Israelites were defeated so many times. And the key verse in the book of Judges is found in chapter 2, verses 18 to
19.
But before that, friends, throughout the entire book of Judges, we see a repeated cycle of sin. And we will talk more about
that.
But let us look at Judges chapter 2, verses 18 and
19.
I'll read it first, and Lube will read it after. Whenever the Lord raised up a judge for them, he was with the judge and saved them out of the hands of their enemies as long as the judge lived. For the Lord had compassion on them as they groaned under those who oppressed and afflicted them. But when the judge died, the people returned to ways even more corrupt than those of their fathers, following other gods and serving and worshiping them. They refused to give up their evil practices and stubborn ways.
Ufatuina Yova Fapasino Moilato on the Yaina or Yova Malfamasino, Maufa Olaina Ilato, a limo, waita yate lato, Yaso Umor Famasino, Awawasala Moyova Yolato Feoi, on the Oe Ufasawam Fatting Ayate Lato, Vipusumariva, Awo in Otio Famasino, Nolato di Liwa Ilea, was silly for Ilolato Langa Yolato Tama, in a Walato Murimuriatu, yet two essay, a our owner, Yai, Maifo Yai.
Remember when the children of Israel settled in the Promised Land? They had no political ruler until the time that God raised up a judge to judge the nation of Israel. And when the judge passed away, and because the children of Israel did not destroy all the enemies in the Promised Land, and they lived side by side with their enemies, and they were influenced by their enemies, slowly they went into idolatry. Defeated by the enemies. They live under bondage. And then oppression. And they cry out to God. And then God raised another church. Deliver them from the hands of the enemies. They live in peace and prosperity until the church passed away. Then slowly they fall into idolatry. Enemies defeated them. They live in bondage and oppression. Then they cry out to God. God hears their voice. And then he raised another church. And they live and defeated the enemies. Now they live in peace and prosperity until the church passed away. No more leader to guide them. Slowly they are influenced by the enemies. They go into idolatry, influenced by the surrounding nations, defeated by their enemies. They live under bondage. And then come to a time they cry to the Lord. God hears their call. God raise another church. Deliver them from the hands of the enemies. They live in peace and prosperity until the church passed away. But friends, every time the church passed away, they sin and even get worse. So this is the cycle of sin in their life. In each of these scripture here, this one here, it is always started with this phrase over. Then the sons of Israel again did evil in the sight of the Lord. But in chapter 2, verses 18 and
19,
it says the people return to ways even more corrupt. It gets worse every time they come back after peace and prosperity. So there was a repeated cycle of sin throughout the entire book. A cycle of sin, bondage, repentance, devotion, followed by sin and bondage again. And they would only follow the Lord when there is a leader. That's why it is important to have a spiritual leader. Again, that is why it is important to have a spiritual leader. And I believe you are very fortunate to have such a leader like Pastor Willie. Again, this is the cycle of sin, friends. Israel serves the Lord. Israel falls into sin and idolatry. Israel is enslaved. Israel cries out to the Lord. God raises up a church. Israel is delivered. Israel serves the Lord. They live in peace and prosperity. But when the church passed away, influenced by the enemies, they fall into sin and idolatry, defeated by the enemies. Friends, this is the cycle of sin in their lives for many, many, many years. Look at this. They live in peace and prosperity for 40 years, 80 years, 8, 40 years, 40 years, 6, and 20 years. So many years. But every time they start again, it gets worse. See, these are what we call as the steps to oppression and bondage. It started off with a partial victory. Remember, God told the children of Israel, when you go to settle in the promised land, you must finish all the enemies.
Ya, mentuan fa yatu le tu ya Israel atau wo le nu for fulanga ya matua fa umatia u malava to fili.
But when they went there to settle in the promised land, they did not kill all the enemies. They left the Jebusites.
Ya alme tu poile ifasotia u malava ya la to fili nei.
And so they live side by side with the enemies. So there was a partial victory. And the partial victory leads to coexistence with the enemy. And coexistence with the enemy leads to cooperation with the enemy. And whether you like it or not, friends, tonight, cooperation with the enemy will also lead to being corrupted by the enemy. Then comes divine discipline. And when they fall into sin, they cry out to the Lord. But the beauty of it all, friends, is that God still hears their voice. My question to you tonight, are we any better? Are we any better today than the children of Israel? We call ourselves as the remnant church members. We call ourselves as the transformed Adventist members. But are we any better today? Friends, when I was in a primary school, probably in class 2, whenever we go to school with my friends, after school at 3 o'clock, we come together to go home. And before we turn to our homes, we come across a junction. One that goes to the sea and one that leads to our homes. And when we will always come and stand in this junction and look over to the sea, look over to our homes and decide on what to do. And then we decide to go and swim. And after swimming, we know what will happen after that. Because when we arrive home, the belt and the sticks and everything, we're ready. And so we'll be receiving hiding from our parents. And they will always ask us, are you going to do it again tomorrow? No more, no more, no more. I will not do it again tomorrow. I'll come back after school. Okay. The following day, after school, we come back, stand at the junction, look to the sea, look to our homes. Look to the sea. Look to our home. When one turn towards the sea, we all follow. And we will just swim as if that there will be nothing happen after. But when the sun sets, we'll come home slowly and look out whether our parents are at home. And we will come slowly and go into the bathroom. Hey, who's over there? Another hiding. You told me you are not going to swim today. But again, you went today to swim. Are you going to do it again tomorrow? No. No more. I will not go tomorrow. Are you sure? Yes. The following day, after school, we'll come back. I remember all the belt and the sticks.
And
we, all of us, and we would be standing there thinking very hard, are we going to go and swim or not? And after a while, the sea was just so attractive. Then we will go and swim. Same thing happened every day. We never learn a lesson. Until our palm becomes black. Are we any better today, friends? Why is it that we are still fighting in the church? Why is it that we are still facing all these problems in the church instead when we call ourselves as transformed members? You see, the psalmists also have the same experience. Before we look at it, you know, when you look at the book of Judges, it's more like a spring cone. This is when you understand this, you understand the whole book of Judges. So it started small, but the cycle is repeated. But every time the cycle is repeated, it gets more, even worse. It is repeated again. But now it's even worse. Friends, why are we still like that? Let us look at the book of Psalm. I will share with you probably the reason why I preach this sermon tonight, and the reason why I think probably the causes for all this. Another picture from the book of Psalms, chapter 1, verses 1 to 3. And let me read probably verse 1 only. Psalms 1 verse 1. How blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, nor stand in the path of sinners, nor sit in the seat of scoffers. Now, there are three very important action verbs in this text. What are those action verbs? Number one is what? Walk.
Savali.
And stand.
Only two.
And sit.
Malenof.
So, in other words, the psalmist is trying to paint a picture of backward progression in life. The book of Judges paints a picture of spring cone. There is a repeated cycle, but it gets worse every time it comes back again. The psalmist is painting a picture of backward progression. You see, when you play around with sin in life, you walk around with sin in life, and you think that you get away from sin, then it will come to a point that you will stand with sin and you start to get serious with sin. And the next thing you'll find is what? You what? You dwell and sit with sin. Which means you can't get over it. You walk, it says over here, how blessed it is the man who does not walk in the counsel. Okay? So you are just walking around. Now you are getting serious. Okay? How blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked, nor stand in the paths of sinners, nor sit in the seat of scoffers. So when you start to play around with sin, friends, don't think that you'll get away from it. Next step, you'll notice that you will stand with sin. And whether you recognize it or not, the next step, you'll find yourself dwelling in sin. No wonder why the psalmist, the wisest man on earth, said this in Proverbs chapter 30, verses 7 to 9. Proverbs chapter 30, verses 7 to 9. O God, I beg two favors from you. Let me have them before I die. First, help me never to tell a lie. Second, give me neither poverty nor riches. Give me just enough to satisfy my needs. Otherwise, I may have too much and disown you and say, who is the Lord? Or I may become poor and steal and so dishonor the name of my God. This is a testimony from the wisest man on earth. The richest man on earth, King Solomon. He said, Lord, give me neither poverty nor riches. In other words, just give me enough, Lord, lest I disown you if you give me more than
that.
My point tonight, friends, is that you see, when you look at that cycle of sin, when the children of Israel live in peace and prosperity, peace and prosperity will always lead to complacency. Whether you like it or not, there's no problem with money. There's no problem with being rich. But from the experience is that when we become rich, we become complacent in life. And when we become complacent in life, apostasy will certainly follow. So peace and prosperity is okay. But please, Lord, just give me enough. That's the testimony from the wisest and the richest men on earth. He had everything. And he knew that's the reason why he was apostatized, because of wealth. Old Testament experience is complacency. New Testament experience is what? What's another word for complacency in the New Testament? That's lukewarm. Lukewarm. What is complacency? Complacency is a feeling of calm satisfaction. Satisfaction with your own abilities. Or situation that prevents you from trying harder in life. And friends, tonight history tells us that peace and prosperity are stepping stones to wickedness and apostasy. You know, honestly with you friends tonight, I preached this sermon here just a month ago. This is the second time I preached this sermon. And I preached this sermon in New Zealand. To the Tongans and to the Samoans, to the Rarotongans, Maorians and Fijians. And I told them what I will say to you tonight, whether you like me or not, that's okay. But I believe this is a message that we all need to hear. You know the main cause for complacency in life? And being lukewarm, because we think that we have money in our hands. We think that money is power. Just because that we are the most educated people in the church, just because we think that we are the richest people in the church, then we think that we have power in the church. Friends, according to history, biblical history, money is not power. Peace and prosperity is stepping stone to apostasy. And I'm not here tonight, friends, to say, oh, you get rid of your money and of your wealth. No. Money is important. God needs your money as well to finish his work. But please do not get that into your head. Please. That's a problem with us. You know, churches, the Tongan churches in New Zealand, they fight as well. When one is angry with the church pastor or with the members, he would go and start another church. When one is not happy, he would go and start another church. And maybe you may smile at me, but the Samoans are also like that in New Zealand, Australia, and America. And when you look at their background, these are people who are influential, then they have money in the church. Friends, tonight, history tells us that peace and prosperity are stepping stones to wickedness and apostasy. That's the cycle of sin in the Old Testament. It is also interesting to see the reaction in America in regards to God after the World Trade Center terrorist attack. Because people are so complacent. After the terrorist attack in America, the sales of the Bible went up by 40%. The sales of the Bible automatically up by 40%. The sales of books on prophecy went up by 80%. Days of prayer have been called for in America, and there were a lot of days of prayer in America after the terrorist attack. And friends, tonight, it is a pity that it takes horrific events such as these to wake people up to these days.
It is
because we are complacent because of what we have in our hands. No wonder why the wisest man testified, "Lord, just give me enough." Because if you give me more, I might disown you. Lord, I don't want to see another tsunami. I don't want to experience another horrific event in life to change my life. You see, this is what happened in Tonga on the month of March, 25th of March 2018, just this year. There was a national day of prayer on Sabbath. That's the king and the queen and the royal family. Government officials also attended. Because in the month of February alone this year, there were a lot of killing in Tonga in 1 month. Accidents happen on Sabbath. Drunken people died on Sabbath, every Sabbath on that month. And so there was a call for a national day of prayer, asking God for forgiveness. Friends, is that what we need today? Do we need another horrific event to change our life? Friends, being transformed does not mean that we are immune from apostasy. Oi, Being transformed does not mean that we are immune from all the evil influences in life. Being transformed does not mean that we are immune from complacency in life. Let me summarize what I have shared with you tonight. Friends, when you destroy your enemies, finish them all. Because if you still allow some of your enemies with you to live with you, remember the steps: partial victory, coexistence with your enemy, cooperation with your enemy, corrupted by your enemy.
Number 2.
History tells us that peace and prosperity are stepping stones to wickedness and apostasy. And we need to be reminded not to allow peace and prosperity. Friends, I'm sorry. Not to allow peace and prosperity to get into our heads.
My family more lovely tanganwenga malafia, our lover ne tatu fatangaina, the tatu soifwangalea, le telo meu tatu mawa, famalia inaitato, e ofi ilo mafu fause tulo.
And one of the reasons why we study history, friends, tonight, so that we do not repeat the same mistake of the past. That's what happened to the children of Israel. We are the lukewarm church, the Laodicean church. We can be complacent as well. But friends, that despite of all this, look at the cycle. When the people cry to God, God hears their cry. No matter how much sin they have committed in life, whenever they call, God will always hear their call. And I'm always amazed how God loves his people. And I don't know why Jesus loves me. I don't know why he still cares for me. I don't know why he sacrificed his life for me. But oh, I'm glad, so glad that he did. Friends, though we have been transformed, we are still an unfinished product. Though we have been transformed, we are still a work in progress. That's why the devil is working very hard to finish us from God. Because he knows that we are an unfinished product. But as long as you allow yourself, every time you come back to God, God will always hear your voice and recreate in you a new heart. hearts. May our good Lord bless us tonight. Amen.
Well, I study the Ecclesia. Yeah, it's grateful to hear this powerful message like this, so that it will help and assist on our transformation. Yele tua nei tu lafia fi faftai lana ona mo le fa utaua fam niele tua ona. Being a fai ole asau nia le Ecclesia mai alo fau fau nai tato sau ninga le fi nei. Walo watu man falo alo le Ecclesia mai alo fau.
Come, please.
Father, thank you for the reminder tonight that you are able. And yes, Lord, you are able to do anything in our lives. And it is my prayer tonight, Father, that as we submit our lives into your hands, despite the repeated mistakes in our lives, that you will renew our hearts, restore us into your glory, and bless us tonight. Though we are transformed, but Lord, we are an unfinished product of yours, and the devil knows that, and he will continue to try to ruin and influence our lives. But again, Lord, as the song says, you are able, and you are able to finish this product soon, so that we all stand gladly with you when you come back to take us home. Bless us all tonight as we dismiss from here. Bring us again, Lord, to another new day of fellowship tomorrow. For we ask all these things in Jesus' worthy name. Amen.